I hate multiple choice questions.
You seem so confusing.
Is this a trick question? Do I go with my gut or do I change?
I always second guess myself.
Did I pick too many of the same letter in a row?
I'm rushed for time.
I'm down to two choices.
Do I just guess?
Multiple choice is great because the correct answer is right there in front of you. But how do you find it, and how can you maximize your score? Using a few simple strategies, you can use psychology to help you pass psychology and other courses with multiple choice tests. First, a bird's eye view and some general strategy. Then, tips from students based on science that will help you bubble your way to success. Last, some myth busting if you have to guess what works and what doesn't. For multiple choice questions, you have to recognize the best answer, and best might mean the most accurate, complete, or inclusive. So start by eliminating the losers. Read the stem, the question itself. Underline or circle clues. You might try reading each question twice. On the first read, identify the topic. On the next, identify what the question is specifically asking about that topic. Focus on what's actually present in the question and answer options themselves. Don't overthink things, don't add words, don't add your own thoughts, or go wild with inferences or implications. Do not compare answers to each other. Judge each choice on its own merit by marking each option with an X if it's wrong, a check if it's right, or a question mark if you don't know. This narrows down your options and keeps you working without looking back. So cross out those wrong choices right away. Don't worry about time for the first half of the testing period. Don't spend time dithering back and forth, just keep moving forward. You are saving half your time to come back to ones you're not sure about. Maybe some other questions in the exam will spark some insight or remind you of something. When the period is half over, if you do not have half the questions done, now you want to start budgeting time. Those are some general tips. Here are some tips on test taking based on science. Now it turns out that what a lot of students actually do works and is supported by science. A survey of students in a large lecture class of the most common major on the IU campus found that there are two ways students succeed with multiple choice questions.
I look for keywords and context clues.
Instructors have to give you identifying clues to let you know what material the question is referencing. So mark the words that remind you of particular lectures or readings. This might include concepts, technical terms, names, dates, events, historical periods, words from flashcards that you studied, what the teacher or book mentions or spends a lot of time on. Every term or example from class is a potential retrieval clue that can help you recall the correct answer. Having trouble picking keywords or confused about what the question is asking? Try putting the question into your own words, or think about it like this. Most multiple choice questions can be divided into two types: definition questions or relationship questions. Definitions test your understanding of the meaning or definition of a concept or term. Relationships test your understanding of the relationship between two or more concepts, like cause and effect, chronology, processes, compare and contrast, example or scenario, application, something like that. Read the question and mark the keywords that will help you figure out which one it is. Check out the website to look at some examples. Assuming you recognize some of the keywords in the question, what strategies can you use to hone in on the best choice?
I choose the one that makes the most sense.
I choose the one that sounds the most familiar for the subject.
These are cognitive or thought strategies. They use memory or learning processes to access or associate with things you learned. These are best if you studied. What about when you can eliminate a couple of bad answers and are down to two? What about when you have no clue? Keep watching. When you are down to two possible answers, there are metacognitive strategies or thinking about thinking strategies that can help. Focus on each choice separately, again, looking for cues or clues, terms and examples you recognize. Look also for alarm words. Alarm words include absolutes like always and never, which make a choice more limited and often incorrect, and qualifiers like sometimes or often, which makes a choice more inclusive and often correct. Alarm words also include negative words like no or except, and even negative prefixes, dis, non, un. Check out the big list of alarm words on our website. When they have no idea or feel they are doing badly on the exam, students sometimes resort to psyching out the test itself. These are called test-why strategies, like when in doubt, see your way out. pick the longest answer, and stuff like that. This is when you really have to guess. Do these work? Some do, and some might. Let's do some myth busting.
I shouldn't change my answer or second guess myself. I'll just stick with my first instinct.
Myth. Many people believe this, but research shows that the majority of answer changes are from incorrect to correct. We only doubt this because we usually just notice the times we changed and regretted it. We tend to overlook the instances where rethinking helped. So if you have a sense that you should change, go with it.
When in doubt, see your way out.
Be smart.
Myth. Strategies to guess a consistent letter choice have actually been found to negatively affect test performance. Don't worry about getting too many of the same answers in a row, and don't necessarily guess a middle letter choice.
The longest answer is probably the right one.
Some research says about 2 times as long and some 3. A few words likely doesn't mean much though.
If 2 choices are similar or complete opposites, one of them might be the right answer.
Maybe. According to some studies, if you have to guess, go ahead and guess one of them if you haven't any other basis for deciding.
Choose the middle value.
Another maybe. Some studies suggest that if all answer options are numbers, avoid the most extreme values and choose the value that is sequentially, if put in numerical order, in the middle. Now for the recap.
Don't worry about time until halfway through.
Read the question and mark it up looking for reminders and key terms.
Take each answer and consider it separately.
Mark those up too, with a check or an X or even a question mark if you don't know.
If you're really puzzled before guessing, think about what type of question it is.
Is it a definition or a relationship question?
Studying early and often can help a lot. Distribute your study weeks and days before the exam in smaller segments to help the memory processes and your scores too.
Being a good test taker comes naturally to some, but you can learn to approach a multiple choice test with confidence. Having some strategies can help you get control A, some of the time, B, most of the time, C, all of the time, or D, all of the above.